cute this snow couple is. So adorable, right? This entire scene here is done with the help of a stencil, which makes the birch tree background, and then a die cut set. You get all these dies in the one set, and it's really so much fun. It's kind of like dress-up dolls, but snowmen. It's so cute. So we're going to put this together today. I hope you'll stick around and join me. Hi, Heidi. Welcome. Okay, so the supplies I'm going to use. For gluing parts and pieces together, for the most part, I'm going to use liquid adhesive. You could use whatever kind of adhesive you want to use. If you like a tape runner, I would recommend the Tombow Dot, because this will only stick to where there's glue to stick to. We have lots of teeny tiny little bits. I like this glue. Mono Multi is a great glue, this one. Or Multi Matte Medium. The advantage of this guy is that it dries totally matte and you won't see any if you use a little too much. Okay, we're gonna do a little bit of blending. The inks I'm gonna use are gonna be Distress Oxide. We'll use those through the stencil and maybe something else. And then stick around to the end, because you're gonna get to see how to use the snow marker. This is snow in a marker form. Let me show you what it looks like when you're done. See this very, very textured snow that they're sitting on? Look at it from the side. It's thick, it's puffy, it's like magic when we heat it up. I can't wait to show you that. It's gonna be my favorite part. All the cardstock I'm using today is white. All of the white stuff is white card maker's choice. You can get this in big packs like this one and just cut it down, or you can get pre-cut cards and or layers and all that good stuff. And I might throw in some stamps for a greeting. I thought these from Lawn Fawn were really cute and appropriate for the snow people. So we might use those on the inside of the card. I'll set those aside for now. And let's start with the stenciling. Okay, so the stencil I'm going to use is also from Lawn Fawn, and it's a two-piece stencil. So when you use this, when you buy this stencil, oops, be careful, they can kind of connect. Okay, you have both just the birch trees or the background of the birch trees, and you can use these together to create colored birch trees and a colored background. On this one, I only colored the background, and I faded from blue to this really pretty like taffy peach color. So we're going to go through and show you how to do that. I'm going to use my glass mat. You could use whatever kind of mat that you have that you can clean ink off of. The station mat is fantastic for that. I have a piece of paper somewhere that I trimmed to the right size, and I put it somewhere for very safe keeping. Very safe. I need to find it now. I'm going to cut a new one. Okay. Pardon me while I do a little trimming here. I need a 4. Oh, that one is 4. Okay, good. 5, 5. That does not seem like a 4. Yeah, that's better. 4, 5, 5 1/4. There we go. Okay, this is what my birch trees are going to live on. Okay, so I'm going to do just the background. So how you can tell which one is which, you get both of these in the set. If I put this down, what do the holes look like? The holes look like the trees. So if I color over this with, let's say, blue, I'm going to have blue birch trees and a white background. If I put this one down, the trees, the birch trees themselves, will be masked off. That means they will be, say, the color of your paper. And I will be coloring the background or the sky. So that's what I'm going to do this time. If you like this stencil set, I would like it to encourage you to check out our upcoming event called Winter Open House. It's 2-3 weeks away. And you want to go into the store and get an invite anytime now, between now and then. I think it's November 11th and 12th, or 10th and 11th, whatever that Friday, Saturday is. That is when we're having an open house event, and one of those days we're doing a really fun in-store make and take where you get to play with this particular stencil set, and for the fee of the thing, you also get to keep it. You get to take this home along with the card that you make. So that's exciting. Oh, and there's other goodies too, but I digress. Let's get going on making this little gem here. Now on my card design, I don't need the stencil to go all the way down here because I'm going to cover this area up with a snow quote. So I'm going to use a little tape. You could use washi tape or regular tape, but it would be best if you use something that is very, very low tech. I like pixie tape because it's designed for this process and you can use it right off the roll and you can reuse it many times. If you use washi tape, bring your shirt into the frame and just rub it on your shirt to pick up a little lint, and that will help keep it from pulling up your paper. I'm going to use a little bit of it and just secure my cardstock down here, whereas I'm going to cover that up with snow anyway. Then I'm going to place my stencil where I want it, and right there looks good. And I'll use this tape to secure my stencil in place. This particular stencil is fairly delicate because it's all been, you can see how easy it would be to rip it, so just be gentle. And so for this card, I had used salvaged patina at the top, and then I blended that down into saltwater taffy. I thought this time, let's try a little different color combo. So I have got evergreen bough, and how about shaded lilac? I can't wait to see what those two look like together. I haven't done this combo. I don't know what it'll look like, but let's find out. I think we'll do the purple at the top. I'm going to show you two different methods too for applying the ink. I'm going to use this one as a sponge. I like this dome shaped ones. I'm going to press down onto the ink pad and move it around, pick up the ink. Yes, open houses is an exclusive thing to in-store locations only. So if you're lucky enough to be near one or can travel to one of our store 7 locations, it is so much fun. It's the best night of the year. Well, actually day, we've moved it to daytime, and we have it either on all day Friday or all day Saturday, and there's prizes, there's really great discounts, and it's just a really fun time. Okay, so I kind of want to concentrate on the top. My stencil is so delicate. See how I could easily move these? Yeah, you can see that. So I want to be careful to go with the lines of the stencil. In this case, my trees are going up and down, so I'm going to kind of move my ink pad or my ink blender in those directions. So I'll start by laying down some ink, and there's ink that sits on top of the plastic stencil. I'm going to be using that as I move my blender about. So I'm going to kind of get this whole top area covered in this purple. It's a pretty shade of lilac. And now I'm just going to go work my way down, trying not to wiggle the stencils too much. I'm using a little less pressure, and you notice I did not re-ink. So I have a lot more concentration at the top, so it's darker up here. And then I'm not pushing as hard, and I haven't re-inked. So it's fading down to a lighter color. Now you can just continue this the whole entire way and just have it fade from dark to light the entire direction if you wanted to. But let's try adding a little of that green. Just a little bit's gonna show at the bottom. That's a pretty color, shaded lilac. This color's been out for so long, and I only just recently finally broke down and got this color because I didn't think I would use it that much, and now I love it. Okay, and now let's do the evergreen bough. This time I'm gonna use a bristle brush. I used a light blue before, so I'm just gonna rub it off on some paper towels to get most of that ink off of there so I can have a, I just like to keep to the same color family. You certainly can clean these, just run them under water, but they take a little while to dry. They need to air dry. Okay, let's pick up some of this really pretty evergreen bough color. And now I'm gonna start at the bottom and work my way up. My tape is gonna be in the way, but I don't care about that because I am gonna put snow at the bottom anyway, the very bottom. Now, if you did care about that, you're like, well, what do I do if I do care about that? Then the tape that I put here, you would fold into a little loop and put it underneath to help secure your paper in the right spot. Okay, now I'm just gonna gently, I'm just doing this motion, kind of down and lifting up at the end, down and lifting up at the end to fade it into the purple. ordinarily I would always go in circles, but I don't want to fudge the stencil like that. So that's why I'm just going with the flow of the stencil. That's really fun, different look. This exact stencil is really fun to do for springtime, and I think these colors would work for springtime, but also for fall. You can make the most beautiful Thanksgiving cards with this if you wanted to. Okay, so let's reveal what we've done. This is the best part of stenciling. Ooh, that is pretty. That is a really nice color combination. Isn't that fun? And here it is compared to our original. Feel free to ask questions in the comments. If I don't see them when they happen, I'll try to answer afterwards. Really fun. And the same exact stencil, same technique, just different colors and a very different feel. Now, I'm going to put this back where I had it. So I want to show you. Okay. The other half of that stencil, if you were going to do it. Remember, this one I didn't. This was this. My sample card here is just the one layer doing just the background. Here is the positive of the trees, and these do line up. So if you have it backwards, they don't line up. So just remember, you got to turn it around. It's kind of like a puzzle. And what I'm looking for are, see how these little branches stick out? Look for its mate. There it is. See how it just fills right in. And now only the white is showing. So if I shift it a little, that's not right. That's not the, right there. And that's right. So if you wanted to kind of give the trees a little color, that's how you would line that back up, and you can tape down your stencil a little bit. And if you want to make this just a little bit more of a dynamic stenciled look, or to, you know, have that sort of multi-layer, this will look particularly pretty if you do it in the fall colors. But I'm going to grab a brown shade. Let's try a vintage photo. I like using distress oxides because they're a dye and pigment fusion of ink. And so I get lots and lots of color and a lot of really pretty color payoff, but they're nice and creamy like a pigment, so they stay wet a little bit longer. It makes them really, really blendable. But they're also water reactive, so I can do really cool techniques with that as well. Let's see, do I have a brush that is kind of in the brown family? I kind of want a detail-y brush. This one will work right here. This is just a smaller version of the other one I was using. You can get these in from small to big. These are the life-changing blending bristles, brushes. They have thousands of silicone bristles and they're domed, so that makes for easy blending. I don't want brown trees, I want white trees, but I'm going to put a little bit of brown highlight here and there. I don't want too much brown on my bristle, on my brush, so I'm going to kind of pounce it off on the side. And then I'm just going to just ever so gently here and there add just a little sort of highlight or color. Notice I'm kind of following the line of the stencil again. Just giving it a touch color. This would be very pretty in grays. If you want to make a very snowy look, do a very light gray on this. Would be nice. I'm just barely touching it. You can kind of see little bits of brown here and there, because I don't want a brown tree, I want a white tree. I think that's good. All right, let's reveal the best part. Woo, pretty. I'll give you a close up. It might be hard to see in the camera. See how the brown just added just a few little highlights? You could actually, if you're very, very subtle and careful, you could do black or a dark gray as well. Paula wants to know, how can you revitalize the oxide inks if you haven't used them in a while? The answer I'm about to give you is true of every ink pad, okay? The best thing to do is, if you feel like your ink pad is dried out, if you store your ink pads like this, or like this, or any direction except for this, then your ink may have shifted or moved, and like sunken gravity wise and moved to the bottom or the side. So what I recommend people do is to turn them over and leave them that way for 24 hours. If in 24 hours and you try to ink it again, it's not fresh and inky, and it still has dried out, then your ink pad is dried out. In that case, you need to get, the best thing to do is either buy another one or buy a refill for it. You can buy the refills online. It's almost as much money as buying another ink pad, and so you might as well just buy another one and replace it. But to extend the life of ink pads in general, I'm talking about all brands, the best thing to do, in my opinion, is to store them upside down. Now, there is something a little bit different with distress oxides in that the ink is suspended in the sponge, if that makes sense. And so gravity doesn't really help an oxide ink very much. So this doesn't necessarily do much for you because it's suspended in there, and it's the pressure pushing on it that sort of releases the ink. It's just that kind of a sponge. But that answer of keeping your inks upside down is what will keep the ink at the top. So like my Hero Hues here, I store it this way so that I can always have fresh wet ink at the top when I'm ready for it. I hope that answers your question. There is a product out there. It's in a bottle, looks something sort of like this, and it's called Ink Refresh. That will give you two, maybe three more uses. And it's just like, you just are spraying the top of the ink and it will be diluted. So personally, I'm not a fan of that product, but it'll get you by, like I say, for a couple of more uses. But I don't think the more you use it, the more diluted it gets and the more your ink is compromised. It's not the same makeup anymore. So I say get a new one, get a new ink pad. All right. And then for cleaning your stencils, you can just clean them with water. The fastest, easiest thing to do would simply be to hold this under running water, and the ink just falls right off. If you're not near a sink like me, I'm just gonna spray it with some water. And the stencils are delicate, so you don't wanna scrub them all every which way. So more of a blotting and going with the direction and making sure you're getting both sides. If you're doing this in between projects, like I need to clean it and then I'm gonna go back with the same stencil, make sure it's completely dry. If it's not, then the water on the stencil, the remaining water or moisture, can affect the ink you've already laid down. So that's something to keep in mind. So you wanna make sure it's dry, and also make sure that your mat that you're working on is dry before moving on, just because the water's gonna activate that ink. All right, so we'll get that all cleaned off. Thank you for the question, Paula. That was a good one. So we've got that guy. We'll set him aside, but that's what we're going to build on. Bring back our sample card here. So now we're moved on to the Lawn Fawn die cut set, this cute snowman. I've put them on a little magnetic sheet here. It just helps me keep track of all these teeny tiny pieces. First thing we're going to do is cut out our snowman. Snow people, if you will. I'm going to bring in my die cut machine. You can use whatever brand die cut machine you have. This is the Fold Away from Sizzix. This is the Tim Holtz version. I've got some white paper. I'm going to cut out my snow people. So when die cutting, you have a bumpy side and a smooth side. Bumpy side goes down onto your paper. And as long as your paper fits on your cutting mat, you are good to go. I'm going to complete the die cut sandwich with another cutting pad and crank it through. This is a simple die cut. It just needs the one pass. Oh my gosh, these are so cute because they're stitched as well. So let's bring these guys up. Here's the little shorty guy. And here's the taller one. And now it actually cuts out the little white pieces here, which, I mean, you could cut this out again in a different color and save them, but I'm just going to pop these out and I'll show you a cool thing that's included in this die cut set to help with this. Okay, so I popped all those guys out with a die pick, almost all of them. There we go. Okay. So you certainly, look at all these teeny tiny dots. Can you see them? How tiny that is? I don't want to fuss with all that. That's a lot. So in this die set comes this oval shape that doesn't really go with anything. So if you cut the oval shape out of black, it fits right behind the little face. And so you can put glue on that and glue it right there. And then peeping through the holes is the black color, and you don't have to painstakingly put little tiny black dots in all of those spaces. So that's what that weird oval shape is for. Okay, so I've got my little snow people that I want to dress up. You can see here that I've already been cutting out some things, but these are cut out of straight paper. So you can find cardstock in the colors that you like, or I like to use a little bit of pattern. So these are, I think, doodlebug papers, I think these are doodlebug. But you can find cute papers that you like that are in the colors you like and just die cut them. You can see I've already see all my holes in there. So I've die cut some of them, but I also want to encourage you to just use your plain white paper. If you already have your ink pads out, you can do that. So I thought, let's do some little snow mittens. And then on this one, I haven't pulled this all the way apart, but I also have like the cuffs here. So we could cut all of this out as well. And there's a couple of things you can do. We can color the paper and then die cut it, or we can die cut it and then color it. Okay, and then we'll just crank that through. We'll color this after. Okay, so I have a white top hat. I've got a white mitten. I've got two white cuffs for the mitten. I've got a white earmuff. Here's a little band for the hat. And because I didn't cut these apart, I also have a white for the face. I don't need that, but I just chose not to cut this apart. Because you can see when you get them, they're all connected. And the idea is that you cut the pieces out and then you can die cut just what you want out of just the paper you want. But I don't like to cut them apart any more than I have to because I will lose them. That's just my problem. So, but you can definitely individually cut out all these pieces. And this is a really fun one because you can use a lot of these parts and pieces for dressing up these snowmen in dressing up other things, or even just the parts and pieces on a little puddle of snow. And, you know, you can have a melted snowman. So cute, right? Okay, let's get the die cut machine out of here so we can get back to playing. Where's my other mitten? There it is. Gotta have two mittens. Well, you don't have to, but I want to. Okay. So we've got our little snow people here, and we can start dressing them up. This is where it starts getting so fun. So this one I made a pink scarf to match the pink of the sky, but this pattern paper I have really matches perfectly with the ink color that I chose. So if you wanted a whole coordinated look, you could do that. So one of these two can be wearing a scarf. We can put the scarf on the short one or the tall one. Isn't that cute? And this one with a little bit of a pattern in it. They're so cute. So you can see they just kind of, before we glue anything, let's just kind of dress them up and see how we like them. So that guy can wear the scarf, or this one can. You can mix and match, have them both be wearing the same kind of things in different colors, or they can be twins, or whatever you want. So we have earmuffs. We can have a white top or a black top. Let's see what the earmuffs look like on this guy with a white top. And then there's included in the die cut set are these two little jelly bean looking shapes, which you could use for jelly beans. They are right here on the die cut. Those two sort of eggy shapes or jelly bean shapes are the earmuffs. And then we can layer that right over the top. That is so sweet. Look at that. Yo, Megan, what do you think? Do you like it? You can dress them up with a bow tie. Look, this guy can be all dashing and sweet. Oh my goodness, that's a very special snowman. You can cut out the little sticks for their arms if you want to. They can have them or not. That's up to you. We can put the mittens on them. Would the thumb be up? If he's going like that, I guess his thumbs would be up. So you could put those right over top of the little arms if you wanted to. Did you see how I had to look at my own hands to figure that out? And then these little cuffs, and we can color these. I made them white, but we can color them whatever color we want, or cut them out of a different color paper. The mittens are so sweet. Okay, we can have a top hat. I cut it out of black and white. Let's see. Here's black with a white little band. That's kind of cute. I guess it would go like that. Oh, very dashing. But let's kind of coloring the hat. So I have a white one here. Let's go back to that brown ink and that brown brush. I'm going to make this hat mostly brown, I think. And then let's bring in a little bit of a black color. I'm going to use the same brush. I'm just going to brush off excess brown. To me, brown and black are the same color family. And I'm going to hit all the edges. So that looks like a very well used hat. Hopefully, if you're making snow people with your old clothes, just like scarecrow people, you'd want to use older things, right? Or maybe perhaps things you found at the Goodwill. And now we can kind of customize, and I think it adds a lot of cool, like, look at the difference between the colored one, the cardstock one, and the handcrafted one, hand inked one. Very cool, right? And I think a nice color piece there. So maybe he needs a little lavender. Bring in the lavender of the sky. Let's go back to that. And I'll color this band that really pretty shaded lilac color. This is a very dashing couple now. We'll put that on the brown. Oh, that really stands out too, doesn't it? That's really sweet. I like that. And in the die cut set, you get a little bit of holly. We could put some holly on there. And you even get teeny tiny cluster of berries. Oh my gosh. Put that on there too. Let's see. Oh, that's so sweet. Let's see what that looks like on the tall snowman. Oh, that's cute. That is cute. So maybe these mittens should be purple. Let's do it. So I'm coloring them after I die cut them, which is obviously a little trickier because it's a very small piece of paper, but you could, where's the paper at? You could take the paper and first add color like that and then die cut over that purple section. Okay, let's make some little purpley cuffs. If you have a pair of tweezers or the quick stick tool, you can use that to kind of help hold it for you too, which would also be helpful in picking it up and adhering it where you want it. Okay, those are cute. Those are so cute. Okay, so yeah, I'm feeling purple mittens on this one. Maybe they will both have hands. We do have a little red in the berries, so maybe we do have a little red cardinal. Even the cardinal has a detail. Look at this. We have a wing and the cardinal itself. And so you could pop that right on top of there and have him like fluttering his little, and he can be landing on the little, oh, that's so cute. They're included in the die cut are also these little dots. Now, when I first saw these, I assumed they were the berries for the holly, but no, when you cut out the holly, you get the little cluster, and they're slightly big. So, excuse me. So you can either use them for eyes, or you can use them for bigger berries, or you can use the black dots, or whatever color you make them, for little like coal buttons on your snowman. That is so cute. Now, this shape I'm not using, but here are two tiny oval shapes. Those cut them out of a very, very pale pink or peach, and then you can have little rosy cheeks on your snow people if you want to. I've cut out little, out of orange paper, little carrot noses. If you want them to have a little carrot nose, we can do that. They can be facing up or down or sideways or whatever you want. So cute. Look at that. Oh my gosh. It's so fun. Paper dolls, right? Leanne says it's so cute. Thank you. Okay. Marie thinks the dies are cute. Pam says that you have scraps of distressed colored, oxide colored paper, and they're perfect for customizing your snowman. Yeah, because, oh yes, you made the snowman card. That is a great idea. Save all your little paper scraps, and then you can die cut them later. Okay. Adorable. Okay, so now let's start assembling our little guys. I think that's how they're going to be dressed. Gonna clean up my space a little bit because I will put the heel of my hand right in that. I know me. Okay, so I want to have them, give them a landing place, so I'm gonna find a scrap of white paper here somewhere. This ought to work. This is something I actually embossed. I didn't mean to use an embossed piece, but I think that will work because it's just as wide. So I'm going to tear, and if you tear towards yourself, you get a really cool torn edge. So I'm going to make kind of a little snowy hill. Cutting it, tearing it a little bigger than I think what I need, so I can cut it smaller if I want to. Actually, that texture looks great. That was unintended, but. So let's just hold this over the top of this and see what we think. That's pretty good. Let's see how tall it makes the snowman people, though. I'm going to have to take you, little buddy. I know you're going to fall apart. That'll work, because I can tuck him in there. We still see the green. I think that'll work. So that's going to be my height. What I'm going to do is put glue on these three sides and not in the middle so that I can tuck. Okay, now I'm going to be adding heat to this, so I want a glue for this portion that can withstand the heat. So I'm going to use score tape for this portion. And I'm going to put it along the bottom edge and the two sides. Which is also, by the way, how you would make a pocket. You just would have it completely on those three sides. You wouldn't have any gaps. Alrighty, we'll peel off the paper liner. Also, since I'm using a textured paper, this heavier duty glue will also benefit me. I need fingernails. Alright, I'm going to do a little trick here. I'm going to take my die pick and run it under there to get just the paper off. There we go. Much better. Okay. And I'm going to line this up the very bottom and the sides of my card. But there's no adhesive right here, so I have a little pocket that I can tuck. Okay. Before I add all these guys, I don't want to have my heat tool blow the stuff away, so I'm going to set them over here into a safe zone. And we are going to do the snow marker now, okay? I want to say something, though, beforehand. During this video, I will not be adhering this to a card front, but you can see once it's all done, you could adhere it to your card front. The reason I'm saying that I'm not going to is because when you do this, it makes it really cute, puffy, and you don't want to press down adhesive on the back of that, so whatever glue you're going to put back here, you don't need it to be like maybe like glue dots or foam tape or something like that that you're not pressing and pushing, because we don't want it to deflate. It's not that delicate, but I just don't want it to be smushed. I like the really cute bumpies, so that's my point. Okay, so I'm going to use the scratch paper to help me make sure that my snow marker is primed. And you do not have to have a heat tool for this, but a heat tool makes it way faster and it makes it puff up faster or better too, higher. I've got my heat tool on standby here. Okay, snow marker. Shake it up really, really well. If you don't mix it up, it's going to be clear, gooey, and runny. We don't want that. This snow marker can be used on fabric. In fact, it's also known by the name liquid applique. So if you ever see liquid applique, it's the same exact thing. They just put it in a different barrel and call it a snow marker because it's white. So liquid applique is something, it works exactly the same way. People use it like to write on t-shirts or on your little canvas tennis shoes, that kind of thing, and you puff it up. It's cute. It's kind of an old school craft, but the snow marker lives on. So I'm going to, this tip, you push up and down a few times to make sure that it's flowing and that your color is mixed. Okay, and so that you can control how much is coming out. So I want kind of a big amount of snow, so I'm just going to kind of press this along where I want it. I'm going to give you a close-up here. So this is sort of getting started, and then I'm going to use the tip to move it around. I'm not going to put snow on the entire piece, but on a fair amount, kind of the top bits. And I want sort of a natural looking pile of snow texture. So I'm not like drawing straight lines. I'm just kind of dotting it on here and there. I want it to look kind of like snow drifts. It has a bit of a smell, so if you're sensitive to that, you might want to work in a ventilated area or a larger room. Okay, let me give you a close-up of what I've done. Now you can just let that sit. Oh, it's kind of hard to see. You kind of just let that sit, and it will kind of puff up on its own, but it won't puff as much. I have honestly never puffed on top of a textured paper like this, so this will be a fun experiment. All right, so I'm going to apply heat now. After I'm sure it's not runny, I'll bring it up closer to the camera. So I'm just going to apply heat, and once you see it puff up, kind of like embossing powder, once an area has been puffed, you've got to move on, because you don't want to over toast it. If you do over toast it, you will smell it, because it'll smell like burning paper, and it can even turn kind of a tannish color. But when you're doing it, it puffs. Can you kind of see the texture puffing up? It puffs up kind of like a marshmallow would puff up. Couple of fun things you can do. You can add, before you add the heat, you could sprinkle on a fine amount of like an iridescent glitter to have sparkly snow. Or after the fact, you can paint on some sparkle. My heat tool hasn't been used all day, so it takes a minute to warm up. Michelle says, burnt snow marker is good for s'mores. That's true. That is true. Good for fakes. She's talking about like fake. If you had a cute little stamp or design that had a photograph of s'mores, not real s'mores. This isn't edible. Saying that for, just to be clear. Okay, so we have some texture. Can you kind of see it? The texture of my paper also added to it. And here it is just on smooth paper. Isn't that fun? So you can get different looks here. All right. So time to assemble our little guys here. I'm going to glue the snow people down first. I want the tall one. I'm going to opposite over here. I'm going to put the tall one to this side, to the left. I'm going to put the little face on there too. The little face backing. So he can shine through with little black coal eyes and everything. Okay, I'm going to tuck him right there. That's where he's going to live. A little bit at an angle. So cute. I'm being careful not to smush my snow. And then this little lady, I decided she's a girl. I don't know why. We'll put her, the little black oval shape behind her face. Yes. I know, Lawn Fawn thinks of everything. That is so cute. I made him a little bit similar in height, but that's okay. They kind of look like two little bowling pins right now. Okay, and let's dress up this hat. So he's gonna have this purple band on the hat. A little bit of glue goes a long way. And then the little bit of berries and holly. A mess-free adhesive would be to back the paper that you die cut with a sheet adhesive. This like thin sheets of adhesive that you put on the back of the paper before you die cut it. Then you just go to town die cutting and coloring as usual. And then when you get to the step that I'm at, all you're doing is peeling the paper backing off of the backside and being able to just stick it down like a sticker. I'm gonna use my quicker picker poker picker upper tool, dot of glue. This guy is a lifesaver. So it has a little bit of low tack putty, kind of like that stuff you use to hang posters on your wall, you know, when you're like in your teens, not when you're in your 40s. I don't know, you do you. And then you have this chisel tip on this end, and then you have a pointed tip on the other, and it does come out, so you can use it as like two little tools to help you with this small finite stuff. So that's really cute. Let's pop dot that one. Give him a really dashing hat. I'm going to put it on like that. Oh my gosh, it's coming together. We're dressing up. We're getting ready for the day. Okay, let's do a little carrot nose for him. I like this side of the nose better. That's cute. While I'm on the nose stuff, let's do this one. We'll have hers going the other direction, going up. There we go. That's cute. Aww. So sweet. Okay, we need a scarf. This one I'll glue flat. This part of it I will glue flat. Let's get our little, this part I did pop dot it, but it looks a little funky to me. I'm going to glue it flat this time, the upper part of our scarf. Oh yeah. I like how my two guys are all dressed up to match the sky. I don't know why I did that, but it's cute. Okay, let's give him a little bit of a stick, little arms stick. Sorry about that. Incoming phone call. I'm busy. Not now. Okay. And we'll put his arm going up here. They're reaching to the sky. They're happy as can be. they both do not have to have the stick arms, but I just think they're cute. And I really kind of wanted her to have the mittens, but maybe he should have the mittens. The bird could land anywhere. Could be down here in the snow even. That's actually kind of cute. Should we do the earmuffs? Yeah, let's do the earmuffs. Okay, that kind of cancels out his arm, so that arm's going to be the only one that can hold a bird, if it's him holding the bird, but that's okay. And I chose to put my snowman this way. You could definitely change the orientation of your card and have him go in the other direction as well. Because I have, there's a lot of space down here that I covered up with the snow. And I'm choosing to do the two snowmen together, but you could actually just do one. They don't have to be, you know, they don't have to be together. Oh my gosh, her coordinating earmuffs and scarf. Oh, she is cute. So next Thursday is card club, and it's held over on the Paper Crafts group page for Facebook here for Craft Per House. If you're not a member, join now. I have giveaways to give away. I have a fun demo planned. You get to hang out with, you know, socially hang out virtually with like-minded folks. Paula says, on a tree branch. Oh, yes, of course. Put the bird on one of the tree branches. That is brilliant. She, look, there's a branch right there. Oh my gosh, I didn't even think of that. That is brilliant. Of course. Which branch? That one? I think that one. Plus it helps, it gives a little bit more, that red color makes it a little more festive, right? And kind of ties in his little, the little berries on his holly. Thank you, Paula. Saved the day twice already. Okay. Michelle likes the earmuffs. What have I been calling them? Have I been calling them earmuffs? I don't know. Okay. Can we get the gloves on? If she puts her hands down, perhaps. I do have a little outside room here. I want her... I just don't want her hands to be in a weird spot. I don't know if we need the mittens. This one would be like that. I don't know. I'm not feeling the mittens now. Put a hand down. Let's see. They are cute though. It looks kind of busy to me though. She's very dressed and he's not. I think I just have so much going on. It looks a little bit busy. I think she's just not going to have arms. I think that's just the way it's going to go. I think this is done. To add the sparkle, I'm going to take a little bit of Lawn Fine liquid Stardust. Shake it up really well. On my piece of plastic would work, a glass mat, acrylic block, whatever, just something non-porous. I squeeze out a little tiny dot. This jar will last you forever. And then get a clean paintbrush-ish, clean-ish. Okay, pick up the sparkle. And you can paint right over your snow and make it sparkly. And now, I don't know if you can see. Yeah, there's a little sparkle. And you can make anything else sparkly. We'll make the little birdie have a little sparkly wing. And the berries can be sparkly. There we go. Okay, and then you're just going to mount that onto the card base of your choice. And remember what I said about the being careful of the adhesive that you choose to use on the back of this portion because of the snow. You don't want to deflate that. But that would be what she looks like. Which one do we like better? The softer colors or the purple and the evergreen bough? I don't know. This was brilliant. The bird looks so cute up there. I do like his bow tie. I could still bring that in, but I almost feel like it should be purple at this point. That's adorable though. Maybe he can have some black little buttons. Oh, I have a heart. Yeah, let's give him a heart, like the Tin Man. Let's give him a little heart. Oh, there we go. There we go. Yes. And then that gives me three red elements for your eye to bounce around to. I like that. That's so cute. Michelle thinks the softer colors focus the snowman a little bit better, but the brighter is cute too. Paula says she likes the purple because it looks like it's evening. Eva says they're both adorbs. I agree. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope I see you next Thursday over on the Paper Crafts group, and I do have some fabulous prizes. You're definitely going to want to tune into that one. All right. Happy crafting. See you next time.